It's time once again to check out some of the worst and funniest spam email that I've received.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula. And once again, I'd like to take you deep into the bowels of my Gmail inbox as we look at some of the funniest, weirdest, poorly spelt, and entertaining spam emails I've received in the last 30 days. I would go back further than 30 days, but luckily for me, Gmail only archives that much before it just starts automatically deleting it. Which is great news, because over the last 15 years, I've signed up for accounts on a lot of different websites, and I get plenty of spam, so let's go over to the computer while I show you some of my favorites from the past month. Okay, I got my Gmail spam inbox folder open here. We're going to go in reverse chronological order, starting with the most recent spam email I got, which came to me 9 hours ago from Kiara. Hello, my beloved. I am attracted by virile men who know what they desire in this life and surely discovered the way to reach it. Okay, so I went ahead and clicked the link, despite my better judgment, and it brought me to this. A Russian dating website, yourbride.ru. And why don't you know it? We got people on the site like Olga, 28 years old, 5'2", 105 pounds, green eyes, and blonde hair. I'm getting a university degree. My religion is Christian. Great. No thanks, Olga. I am happily married, and you kind of look like a cross between a plastic Barbie and a robot. Our next spam email from feline@viawest.net, and the title is Heifer and Peter. And it starts off almost incomprehensible. Guido White Rob St. Cosmo Robert White YB, and then a really confusing URL. Mid, he did not have to wait long. Someone in a black mask and a black coat gave a quick squeeze to the tip of his fingers. So it goes from confusing gibberish to actual English in a single word. And it seems like, as I've pointed out in the first spam video, that these emailers just lift wholesale entire lines and paragraphs from novels and books, completely out of context for no reason at all, because they think if they have a string of well-written English together, it might get past the filter. Nice try, but it doesn't. I decided to go ahead and click the link included anyway, just to see what this is all about, and it brought me to a Russian wristwatch website. And I have to say, the site looks kind of legitimate, and the watches look pretty nice. Now I have to say, if I was going to spend 32,000 kroner, or whatever the hell the currency is in Moscow, I would probably be buying a watch from Switzerland, not from Russia. But I have to say, they don't look all that bad. Just, you know, maybe work on your English if you get to spam me, chief. My next spam email is titled, Horny Stag is Desired for a Girl's Night. Howdy there, horny stud. We are on the lookout for a smashing hot stud to entertain chicks for one of these nights. We are heading for a furtive birthday party, and you'll be the only stag admitted. Birthday party? Well, today's Jory's birthday. Are you going to Jory Karen's house for his birthday? Oh, Ricky Anastasia, you are a tricky one. Okay, the next message comes to us from Enlargement Supplement Free Trial Sample. And boy, that is a mouthful. That's what she said. Give her some more of your love rod. Stop jeopardizing your relationship with your mediocre-sized pecker. I resent that, okay? So let's go to fullmite.com and see what they're trying to sell us. Okay, we've seen this site before. Newsflash. FHM. Men's Health. Maxim. Okay, this is so totally fake. The weather today in New York is definitely not 95 Fahrenheit. I mean, on the surface, to a grandmother with cataracts, this might look like a convincing website, but it's complete bullshit. And if you scroll to the bottom, it even includes a comment section. But no matter what day you visit this site, they'll always say the comments were posted yesterday afternoon. And if you look at the very bottom, it ironically mentions that comments have been closed due to spam. I think that's kind of funny that on a spam site, the comments have been closed due to spam. Of course, we all know that's a lie. The comments were never open to begin with. The next email in my spam folder is deal of United States dollars, $450 million. Mr. Victor, please download freely to view the message. Insurance5.pdf. And wouldn't you know it, it's from South Africa's Institute of Financial Markets. This is Mr. Victor Baloli. I am writing with utmost confidentiality and trust confides in you. I would respectfully request that you keep the contents of this mail confidential and do not publish it in a YouTube video to all of your 65,000 subscribers. Now, between the fake Viagra and the Russian brides, I have to say these are my favorite type of spam emails. Because out there, you have to understand, there is a little old lady from Pasadena that falls for this stuff every year. And she happens to think that Mr. Levy Manaswanawana has $450 million that he actually wants to give her for no particular reason. Please again note, I am a family man, and the success and riches never come easy on a platter of gold.
fault. Okay, so right there, Mr. Victor Bololi literally cautions you not to listen to him. He says, good things don't come easily. And yet here he is trying to convince you that good things come easily. Yeah, nice try, Chief, but I think you're going to have to wait a little longer for my immediate response indicating my interest as soon as possible. All right, and our last spam email comes to us from benb0314 at yahoo.ro, and it reads, Privet moya ikke 609-741-392-Somali, Sunday, September 2nd, 2012, 8:47 p.m. Okay, so what is the point of this message? I understand the reasoning behind all the other spam I looked at. It's to get me to buy something, or fall for something, or pay this, or do that. This one doesn't have any links, it doesn't have any ads, it doesn't have any products. What's the point of this? This is the very definition of spam. It's completely useless.
Well, there you have it. Some of the funniest and most entertaining spam email I've collected over the past 30 days. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If demand is high enough, maybe I'll do part 3 sometime next year. But for now, that is the world according to me. My name is John. Thank you for watching and thank you for listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.